Well, bed bugs are in the news right now. You can't go a day without hearing them in the news. And so there's a lot of people that are being scared. And what we do know is that we need to do a lot of education, because we need to belay their fears that bed bugs are a problem, but it's not a problem that can't be fixed with a great deal of effort. And so Cooperative Extension, along with other agencies, requested that we put on a program to help all the counties answer the questions that are coming into them by citizens. The biggest concerns have been for county agencies in particular that deal with assisted living, the hospitality industry, social services that work with low-income housing or people that are in some sort of need. They're going into situations where the houses may be infested, and what they're trying to do is give the best advice on how to fix the problem, and also they want advice on how do they avoid having bed bugs hitchhike with them back home.
Now, do the dogs work?
Yes, and they work several orders of magnitude better than us.
Well, we do know that, you know, humans can detect bed bugs, and we're probably about 30% accurate in going in and finding them. The dogs are about 95% accurate or even higher. And the advantage of using the dog is it takes a lot less time. They can come in and they can pinpoint whether or not there is actually a bed bug problem. And from there, a pest management professional can take appropriate steps to correct the problem. So what we were showing today is, how does this dog work? What kind of advice we give to people to make sure that they're picking a company that has a dog that's been trained properly.
Hopefully that's the right chair.
We don't call them bed bugs for no reason. Most of the time they are going to be on your bed, whether that's the mattress or box spring or the frame. And so what we wanted to do is show people what are the things you look for to make sure that you think you have a bed bug problem. You can't simply go by the bites. We tell people you have to confirm you have bed bugs. So what we want to show people is, this is how you inspect a mattress and look for the characteristics that show you have a bed bug infestation. We know that pesticides work, but we also know that we're beginning to run thin on our arsenal of pesticides, because bed bugs are showing resistance to the common pesticides we have. We're also interested in finding alternatives to pesticides, and heat treatments is one way you can reduce the use of pesticides in fixing a bed bug problem. And so what we wanted to show people was how exactly it's done. This is not simply a matter of raising the temperature in your house. It actually has to be monitored so you know that every nook and cranny of your house reaches that temperature. And that again is why this is not a do-it-yourself type of job.